Fort Missoula Regional Park, or the expansion of the existing Fort Missoula Park, was identified as a need in the 1995 Open Space Bond Project. The city purchased 100 acres of land from the University of Montana in 1997 using Open Space Bond dollars. In 2001 and 2002, we went through our first major extensive public process to get to a conceptual master plan, which was actually designed by Rockingham Design. And from 2002 until 2008, we went through the Federal Antiquities Act and State Historic Preservation study, which means we did ground penetrating sonar. We studied the importance of Fort Missoula, and we learned what the contributing factors are to the historic district. In 2008, we completed our mitigation plan, which said that we would interpret the Civilian Conservation Corps of History of Fort Missoula Regional Park, which is a pretty cool thing, and that's why this architecture is absolutely phenomenal with the logs and the stone.
A contractor out of the Bitterroot constructed this off-site, brought it on-site as a kit and put it together. We have throughout the park, and you don't see a concession building on this phase. One of the things we wanted to get rid of is, when you have a concession building, you only have one type of food that you could really focus on. And so throughout the park, you see some on our post right here. You can see one over by the shelter or by the playground. We did RV, we call them RV hookups, but they're basically a concession hookup.
We're so excited to for her and all of us to share this wonderful event on Saturday, grand opening of phase one. Missoula County residents have been significant partners in this project. As you know, this was a city-county bond that was approved, and voters all over the county paid for this park. We're so excited to share the grand opening of this amazing regional and cultural destination, not to mention the recreational piece as well. If you turn around, the Historical Museum at Fort Missoula is just a stone's throw away. We're envisioning people from all over can come and spend a day here, recreating, playing, gathering with their families, and enjoying all of the history surrounding you as you stand in this area.
The lifespan, depending on your maintenance, ongoing, like cyclical maintenance, is probably 8 to 12 years. The company that installed this field has some in play that are 12 to 15. So I think it just depends on your ongoing maintenance. Same with your vehicle. If you change the oil frequently and everything, you could get 300,000 miles out of your car. Or if you neglect it, it
kind of... You have to cover it in the winter?
No.
Nope, just let it go.
Yeah. But then is there like an ongoing sort of financial plan for knowing that eventually that replacement will have to happen, whether it's a decade or whether it's 15 years, best case scenario?
Yeah, in our rental fees, we put some aside in the enterprise account that covers the replacement costs of stuff. Similar to the nets, like the nets on the soccer goals go out, it's a similar process.
I'll never forget, I was out here working, getting things set up before our very first rental. This was back in November, and it was a youth soccer team. I'll never forget, the first two kids came in and they literally just ran straight onto the field, threw a soccer ball out, kicked it maybe twice, and one of the kids he said, "Dude, this is like the best field ever." And I have that burned into my brain, how happy this kid was. And of course, all the parents keep coming and the coaches come.
The rugby pitch was the last field that we sodded last fall. With all the rain that we had in October, we actually sodded this about during October or slightly in the beginning of November. This field is catching up quickly to the other ones just because of the aggressiveness of the sod. You can see we've been mowing it to try to get, to help encourage that root growth down instead of coming up through the grass.
Wanted another way into Fort Missoula without going past the internment camps. So one of the reasons that diagonal road was cut in had to do with basically finding a different way to the museum area or to the military post. So it's pretty interesting. It's one of the reasons we didn't want it to be a public right-of-way. With public right-of-ways, there's utilities and other things that have rights to those rights-of-way. And by making it a private park lane, even though the park is public, we're able to control what goes through this route because of its historic significance. We have the ability to do all those things. And what we're trying to do is provide something Missoula didn't have before. The other thing that really excites me about this park, you know, in 1902, the Greeno family donated Greeno Park, which is one of the entire county's most popular parks, because we poll countywide which park is the most popular, which one do you use most. And that one in Fort Missoula, and then McCormick and Playfair because of Splash and Currents, are four of the most popular parks, city and county residents alike. 61% of county residents use existing Fort Missoula Park. 61% of city residents use Fort Missoula Park. That's fantastic. So we add these new facilities aimed at residents. As a design team, project team, we spent a lot of time on what makes this park pertinent to the people who live here or around here within a 30-minute drive on a daily basis. So going back to that Greeno story, think of what Greeno Park was. Think about our Bonner Parks and those first amazing parks that were donated so philanthropically to our community. And they define our people and they define our place and they give us pride in where we live. It causes us to want to be outdoors and be more active. Well, this is a gift that county residents gave themselves. Because it doesn't work so well anymore for somebody to donate that many acres of land and to donate that kind of development and meet all the new codes and all the special things we have to do to make a place special. But Missoula County residents came together and said, let's create history here today by investing in the people who live here today and the people who will be here 50 and 100 years from now. So that, I think a huge gratitude to our voters and all of the people in Missoula County who understand the value of really incredible public places.